Hi, I'm Matt Weed, Senior Director of Product at Luminar Technologies. I'm here at CES 2022 and going to talk a little bit about the technologies we've been developing and looking to deploy in the next few years. A big priority for Luminar over the last couple of years has been getting deeper and deeper into software development based on our LiDAR technology. So building point clouds is great, but doing something with them is even greater and allows us to have better and better impact. And so that's really what our focus has been, trying to find ways to extract understanding from the point clouds, but then be able to have vehicles plan and act to be able to have really strong functionality in the field. Bringing our technology into the real world is really important, but as a baby step before we set it loose on the streets, having activity on the test tracks is essential. So we've been doing that a lot over the last year, bringing our LiDAR integrated into vehicles, bringing it on the track, bringing test targets and dummies to bear so that we can test this before we bring it into the real world. And what we've been working on and underpinning a lot of what's driving our company forward is called proactive safety. The ability to give a vehicle understanding about what's going on in the environment with enough time and distance so that it can act proactively to save lives. And proactive safety is special because it operates regardless of who's in control of the vehicle, whether it be you as a human or an automated system like a robot. It underpins the safety envelope of the vehicle, whether you're in neighborhoods, on highways, in dense traffic, in open roads. So let's take a look at how it operates in a neighborhood. So if we think about what a vehicle needs to know to be able to operate safely, we look at the understanding it needs to have about its environment. So we understand the free space where it can drive. So the road as differentiated from curbs or the sidewalk. We look at the detection of how that road space is broken up into lanes, see road crossings, as well as the detection of pedestrians, cars, obstacles, any of those kinds of things and their relation to each other in that drivable space. As an example case, what we'll look at here is the example of a child chasing a ball into a street in a neighborhood at the end of the day with poor lighting. In this scenario, the car is traveling 25 miles an hour. At first detection of this child, we're at about 15 meters away, about 1.25 seconds. That gives us time to start proactively preparing the vehicle to perform a maneuver, whether the human initiates that maneuver or we have to as a safety system. Within that 1.25 seconds, we now need to maintain 10 meters, which is about a half a second of time to perform the braking maneuver, which gives us a little bit of time to do some things in the vehicle. So in this time, we're preparing the brake system. So we're starting to prime the brakes, run brake fluid so that when we perform a maneuver, the vehicle is more responsive. We can start sending signals to the vehicle's restraint systems to start tightening the seatbelts in case of this eventual braking condition so that they're more comfortable as passengers. We can start sending alerts to the driver to try to draw their attention to where it needs to be in the driving scene. All of these things give us the proactive nature of the vehicle system so that when the action needs to happen, the vehicle's ready and prepared. And as the scene progresses and the vehicle continues driving, gets closer, we find ourselves now 10 meters away, confirming detection of this child. With about half a second left, that means we're in that window where we need to take action. The driver hasn't initiated the braking maneuver, and so we take over, and with all of the preparation we've had, we're ready there to make the maneuver happen, stop the vehicle in time to save the child's life. So this is a moment that really could have been tragic for, of course, this child, for the driver, but we were able to avoid it. And that's really what drives the mission of proactive safety forward. But proactive safety isn't just for neighborhoods, isn't just for driver support. When moving into the world of autonomy, the highway is the place that we'll first see consumers with vehicles that will be able to drive themselves competently. The hard part is making it possible to be safe and reliable as it's driving. And so we see here standard highway driving. Again, very simple. We look at what the LiDAR sees as it drives through this scenario, being able to understand the road, where the road edges are, the picking up the lane markers and all the other cars and road users and knowing where they are in those lanes. But again, this is the easy part. When proactive safety has this underpinning, however, keeping out for weird things, dangerous things, dynamic things that happen. In this case, what we see is a truck that's ahead of us, our lead vehicle, starts to lose cargo. So if we look at the freeze frame of time when this happens, this cargo is now hitting the road about 100 meters ahead of us. We're able to detect that really well, understand exactly how large this debris now is, where it is that it is indeed in our lane, and how far away it is, so that we have a very accurate understanding of what, again, our time to collision would be. In this case, because we're able to detect it so far ahead, we've got a lot of time. We've got 3.5 seconds. Now, this is not a lot of time when you're driving 65 miles an hour, as in this case, but what this allows the system to do now is plan and adapt and think about what we can do instead of just hitting the brakes again. In this case, what we see is that we have time to be able to identify space in a neighboring lane, be able to make that maneuver, and really importantly, have enough time to tell the driver, hey, we're going to be making a maneuver. This helps build confidence in autonomy systems so the vehicle doesn't start moving without any warning. And this is the kind of thing that proactive safety and autonomy live symbiotically. These are not two separate technologies. Proactive safety underpins all of the things that are possible in these vehicles, and autonomy kind of emerges from that safety envelope. So as we go forward into the next year, it's really exciting to see ourselves moving into functions, showing the world what's possible, finding ways to integrate these solutions into our customers' full vehicle stacks, driving deeper and deeper into what's possible with LiDAR, all the way from sensing through action.